Good morning to all. Now we will discuss about our topic, Human Anatomy and Physiology. Human anatomy is the study of structure of the human body. Anatomy notes the position of structure, organs such as muscles, glands and bones. A person who studies anatomy is an anatomist. Human physiology is the science of how the human body functions in health and disease. Physiology is referred to the physical, mechanical and biochemical function of human tissue or organs. A person who studies physiology is a physiologist. All multicellular organisms are organized at different levels of starting with the cell and ending with the entire organism. These include the chemical, and the chemical is the atom and molecule. Cellular, tissue, organ, organ system and the organism level. Higher levels of organization are built from lower levels. These are seven systems of the human body. They are integumentary system. It includes hair, nails, sweat glands, oil glands. Next one, skeletal system. Next one, muscular system, endocrine system, cardiovascular system, lymphatic system or respiratory system, digestive system, nervous system, urinary system, reproductive system. First one, integumentary system. The integumentary system is the set of organs forming the outermost layer of an animal's body. It compresses the skin and is appendages acting as a physical barrier between the external environment and the internal environment that is serves to protect the maintain. The skin is only a few millimeters thick yet is by far the largest organ in the body. The average person's skin weighs 10 pounds and has a surface area of almost 20 square feet. Skeletal system. The human skeleton is the internal framework of the human body. It is composed of around 270 bones at birth. This total decreases to around 206 bones by adulthood after some bones get fused together. The bone mass of the skeleton reaches maximum density around age 21. Five major functions: body support, facilitation of movement, protection of internal organs, storage of minerals and fat, and blood cell formation. The largest bone in our human body, femur, found in leg region. The smallest bone in our human body, stapes, found in middle ear. Then muscular system. The muscular system is an organ system consisting of skeletal, smooth and cardiac muscles. It permits movement of the body, maintains posture and circulates blood throughout the body. The largest muscle in the human body, gluteus maximus, found in hip region. The smallest muscle in the human body, stapedius, found in middle ear. Endocrine system. The endocrine system is a chemical messenger system comprising of the hormones released by internal glands of the organism directly into the circulatory system, regulating distant target organs. It regulates all biological processes in the body, includes growth, development of the brain and nervous system, etc. In vertebrates, the hypothalamus is the neural control center of the endocrine system. The major glands of the endocrine system are hypothalamus, pituitary, thyroid, parathyroid, adrenals, pineal body. Next one. Lymphatic cardiovascular system. The cardiovascular system or circulatory system refers to the heart. Lymphatic system. The lymphatic system or lymphoid system is an organ system in vertebrates that is the part of circulatory system and the immune system. It is made up of large network of lymphatic vessels, lymph nodes, lymphatic or lymphoid organs and lymphoid tissues. Lymphoid organs is a bone marrow, thymus, lymph nodes, spleen, tonsils, mucous membrane. Then functions. Protecting your body from illness causing invaders, maintaining body fluid levels, absorbing of digestive tract fat and removing cellular waste. Next one. Respiratory system. The respiratory system is the network of organs and tissue that help your breath. It includes your airways, lungs and blood vessels. The muscles that power your lungs are also part of respiratory system. These parts of work together to move oxygen throughout the body and clean out waste gases like carbon dioxide. Parts of respiratory system: nose, mouth, larynx, pharynx, lungs, diaphragms. functions, gas exchange, oxygen and carbon dioxide, breathing, movement of air, sound production, olfactory assistance, sense of smell, protection from dust and microbes entering body through mucus production, saliva and coughing. Thank you.